Hi everyone and welcome to this video. Today's video again is a pouring video and we are going to make a ring pour. I already did a couple of them but always on a bit smaller size. So this is a 50 by 50 centimeter canvas and therefore I want to scale up a bit. So I even plan to scale it up more. But just let's see how this one is going. And as you can see, I have a different brand of color this time. So just a couple of weeks back, DecoArt has contacted me asking if I want to test their new pouring medium and their top coat, and they sent them over to me including a bunch of their colors, and those colors are really really pretty. And not only the color itself is pretty, most of the colors that they have sent me are more on the pastel range of the color spectrum, so a bit less color intense when it comes to the contrast, but something I have not so much played with. And even the names of the colors are just beautiful. Light buttermilk, baby blue, lavender, sour apple, Indian turquoise, carousel pink and sea breeze. They just sound cute. And besides of the paints, as mentioned, there was the pouring medium, which I've never tried before myself. And I never really used so much pouring mediums in general. I used the Floatwell for a lot of projects, which I do not really consider a pouring medium, but it's not really designed as a pouring medium, it just works great for it. And I've used the Liquitex pouring medium, but this is really thin, so I only used it once. And I've used some acrylic binders, which I also currently using from the Gardi brand, which comes from Bosnia, which is a local art brand, so to speak. So I've never used the pouring medium from DecoArt, so I'm really really curious how this works, and of course I can't wait to play with these colors. So in the very beginning it's always about the color mixing, and as I did not use any of these products before, I want to show it in this video as well, although I normally just speed it up. So the small cups that you can see here are just yogurt cups. As mentioned in my last video, I'm really on the environmental saving side. So whenever I encounter something I have food in which is a round or roundish plastic cup or container, I most of the times just keep them just to see if I can use it for any other purpose. Therefore I just used these yogurt cups because we love yogurt, as everyone does I think. So we just keep them, they are really tiny, so like half a regular yogurt cup. And it's perfectly for the pouring, and I have a ton of those. So you can just reuse them as often as you like. The good thing, if the paint is dry and has a thick layer of paint, you can just peel it out and reuse it again. Or just let it dry and let it sit in there and mix your paint on top of it. It all works. And just when my cups are really, really ruined and dirty, I just put them away in the plastic recycling. Anyways, when it comes to the details written on the pouring medium, it is said that on regular craft paints you should use a 1-to-1 ratio. So with the Americana paints you should use the same amount of medium that you use of paint, which I did. If you have thicker paints, you can increase the amount of the pouring medium just to have the consistency that you like. I wasn't sure if the consistency is what I'm used to, but I mixed it together and those colors blended really, really, really beautiful. There was no chunks of paint, there were no blobs, everything really smooth. They blended in as if they were meant to do. Well, they are meant to do, but you know what I mean. So sometimes pouring mediums or mediums in general give you a harder time mixing colors in evenly, I would say. And this stuff really worked beautiful. It really did. And so I mixed up all the paints that I had, and the consistency is a bit thinner than I'm regularly working on. But I just let it be as it is because of experimental reasons, just to see how they behave on the canvas. If I can work with them the same or if... I don't know. So you will see. So once all my colors were mixed and before I actually pour them into my pouring container, I wanted to make some base layer of paint onto the canvas, especially on the edges to make the paint flow easier, and it did not really cover the entire canvas. And what you can see me doing here is putting down the base layer of paint, which is a dark grayish tone here, and normally I would go for black or white or something like that. So whenever I make a pour, and oftentimes there is a lot of drip off, sometimes more, sometimes less, but whenever I have drip off I don't just throw it away. I normally scratch it off the paper underneath and put it into a container with a lid. And so I put all the paints that I'm getting in there just to have them stored. And this of course gives you a grayish muddy tone. But it really saves you a lot of color, and especially for such a base layer, which you will not so much see through in the very end anyways, it is just perfect. So if you do not do this, I really recommend you doing this. Of course, you will end up having some silicone in this paint mixed as well, so it will be a reactive paint. But anyways, it is still a very cool idea, and of course it will save you a couple of bucks, because you can save on other paints that you would normally would have used for the background layer. This to be said just as an idea. So, but rambling off, and let's start with the pouring itself. For this project here I used a measuring jug, which I normally don't do, but I thought for the ring pour it is a clever idea, and therefore I added all the colors. I poured in from light to dark, because I wanted to have the outside of the ring pour darker, and having some cells and stuff perhaps popping through the black. Having poured all the colors in, I just realized that I have way more light colors than I have of the dark colors, so I expected that the really dark outside background is not going to happen so much. And this here is the real-time footage, so I did not sped up this time. And I really did not breathe that much when I poured it, just to have a more or less consistent flow of the paint. And I really liked how this one looked, perhaps a bit too light in the middle. We will see what we get. When all the paint was poured, it just has to be stretched. And when stretching happens, you never know what you get. So sometimes it really maintains these little rings and is beautiful, and sometimes it just changes completely what it did here in this case. It did keep some of the rings, which is great, but the entire design was completely different than I expected. But I really loved the outcome of it. It really looked great. I can't really tell you what it looked like. Whenever I watch it, I think of some outer space scene as well, like a nebula or something with a bright star in the very middle where the light area is, and some deeper nebula going, I don't know. Make up your mind, and of course let me know in the comments what you see into it. If you like the design, and if you've used these colors as well, perhaps. So I was really happy with the result, which is a good thing for me, especially for such a new attempt on a larger scale, and I let it dry. And something that I realized along these colors is that they dry rather quickly. So I normally have to wait a day or 2 days when I use my regular paints that I'm used to, until everything is dry, because they are thicker in consistency, so a bit more solid. And these paints really dried quickly. It was not even a day until everything was completely dry, which was really cool. So there were no bumps, there was no junk of paint moving around there. It was a really smooth finish, which was really great. I loved it. So when it comes to the color scheme, they are a bit more pastel-like, of course, as I told you, but the consistency is really great. I love it. And I can't wait to play more with these colors and see what I can make out of them. It is, yeah, it's really worth it. So if you are in Germany, die Farben könnt ihr über Reihe bestellen, also R-E-Y-H-E-R, oder einfach auf Amazon. Dort könnt ihr die auch finden, wenn ihr testen möchtet. Die sind auch Single Stock, also ihr könnt die einzeln kaufen, müsst ihr nicht als Set kaufen. Würde ich euch mal empfehlen zu tun. Das pure Medium ist auch wirklich gut, gefällt mir. Und der Topcoat, dazu erzähle ich dann später noch was in anderen Videos, klasse. Der ist wirklich gut. So, yeah, for those of you who did not understand the German part, I just told my German followers where to get them here in Germany. Yeah, and I just recommended them trying it out. And I also told them about the top coat that they also sent me, which I will test out in another video and let you know for this part in detail. So far for this video, I really hope you liked the end result and what I made with it. Let me know in the comments what you think about it, and if you're new to my channel and had fun watching or felt entertained and liked what I did, please give me a thumbs up, and even better, please subscribe to my channel to not miss out any of my new videos, and also have a look at the 180 other videos that are already there. Some of them are really cool. You should really watch them. Besides that, please also tell your friends and family and whoever wants to see what I did here and share the video, which will help my channel grow. So social media links are also linked below in the video description if you want to get in touch with me. And there's also a link to my Etsy store if you want to have something of my arts hanging in your home, which I would be super proud of course. So other than that, thank you so much for your time and see you next time. Have a great day. Bye bye.